Now, these are the major factors that are negative, that negatively impact the case for the personal injury attorney. We got poor record keeping, we talked about. Not being a good quarterback and putting the patient's conditions and other providers that can help them immediately are doing the diagnostic testing. Not responding, and excessive billing and failure to negotiate reasonably. I hate to put you on the spot. Which one of these four or five, would you say what is the number one thing that really you don't like that the doctors inhibit or limit the case?
Documenting the injury.
Okay. Number two. What would number two be, you'd say?
Failure to respond in a timely manner.
Okay. And then number three?
Failure to make appropriate diagnostic testing or
okay.
referrals.
And then four and five would be?
Tardy responses. You know, just
yeah.
I'm sorry.
But that would be number. Let's see. Tardy or failure to respond. That'd be number two.
Okay.
Just not being timely with you.
I think refusal to negotiate.
So that would be number four, and then billing five.
Yeah. That's we might put number failure to reasonably negotiate balance. We might put that even up at number two. That's a big one.
It can
slow the client down to getting to a closing table, to getting the monies to the client that he or she needs.
Yeah, and let's say all the money is there, then this obviously drops to the bottom, or may not even be a factor, right?
Yeah, this we should put this as number one or number two.
Okay, refusal to negotiate, and again, that's if there's limited funds.
Yeah.
Because if the funds are there, the doctor's funds and then the patient's funds and the attorney's funds, then this isn't a one or two, right?
Well, I think they're all important factors, but let's remember the patient client comes first.
Right. Well, we're going to make that assumption anyway. So here's what we're seeing is the negative factors that doctors are doing to negatively impact the personal injury case. And so poor record keeping, and we enumerated those specifically as an initial report, making sure all the chief complaints are covered, accurate prior medical history, all the physical examination findings, all the separate diagnoses, and having a separate plan for those diagnoses. That's all inclusive, and in a narrative report format is what we're looking at. So that number one with number two, failure to respond in a timely manner.
You beg my pardon. Can we go back to the billing, please?
Sure.
Excessive billing?
Yeah.
I remember that example. I was in the courthouse the other day. I was talking to a defense attorney, and you know what the theme of his case was? That chronic pain management doctor was excessive billing, and it was all about greed.
Right. Right.
And that was the theme of the defense attorney's case, and that's what he drove home to the jury.
Oh, in trial.
In trial.
Right.
And so excessive billing can be fatal to a case.
Right. I could see that in front of a jury, too. Mm-hmm. More so in front of a jury than if you're just trying to settle. So, okay, well, very good. And so we've covered the topics on the factors, the negative factors doctors are doing to negatively impact the personal injury case. And again, I'm Dr. Paul, online chiropractic marketing systems with Brad Sauter's personal injury attorney right here in Tampa, Florida. And this is the Chiropractic Personal Injury Marketing Show. You take care. We see you later. Bye.